everybody. Today, my tip of the day is on how to get professional development or credits towards your license. So, if any of you have a teaching license and you're not currently teaching in a brick and mortar classroom, you need to be earning credits on your own to be able to renew your license. So, I live in Utah, and so we have to renew every 5 years, and we have to get, I believe it's 200 points, is what it is. And different things are worth different points and stuff like that. And so, whatever state you live in, I recommend you go to that website. To like ours is the Utah Educators website, and so go to whatever your website is and look up relicensure points, or relicense or professional development or whatever that is, and see what is required for your state because ours have lots of different steps like fingerprinting and other things that need to be done. So just make sure you get all your ducks in a row, and then I have some tips on different ways you can possibly get points towards your license. So for us, the last step is after we've done everything, we take our paperwork and we go and meet with an administrator, so like a principal at a school, and then we show them our work and they sign off on the paper. And then you keep it because you can get audited. So at least in Utah, you need to just meet with a principal. I don't know what it is for other states, so always make sure and find out what yours is. And so it's interesting because for me, it seems like VAP Kid teaching for them, we're doing so much teaching and it should count. But as of right now, it doesn't necessarily count. I have heard of some principals, at least here, who have signed off on that counting for points, but I wouldn't bank on that because it is not fully there. So you can always check with your educational department or with the person who you are getting points signed off on from. So here are some other ways that you can get points. Of course, if you are working towards a master's or some other degree, you can use those towards education credits, which is really nice. You can also sign up to take online classes, Canvas classes, things like that through local schools, and you can pay some money and find some pretty cheap ways to do that. You can also look up professional development classes on the education websites, so make sure to look at that. In Utah, there is on the relicensure this 25 point where it was like basically any teaching thing you are doing can count towards 25 points. And so that's where VAP Kid as of right now can fit in, is in that 25 points. Next, you can always go to conferences. In Utah, we have the UEA conference, but your state may have something different. There's also EdTech conferences. There's lots of different educational conferences that you can attend and possibly receive points for. Next, I keep track of all of my workshops and things that I attend with VAP Kid. I do have a PDF file. I'll try and put that below. It's a Google slide, so you should be able to access it. Make a copy, and then you can keep track of all the workshops you've done. Some principals, once again, they will accept it, others won't. So I just do all this just to cover all my bases. The next thing is I did the TESOL VAP Kid certification, and that may or may not count. So, I mean, that was a lot of hours of work to do, and so you can show it. And once again, it may or may not. TESOL is a recognized company by most educational departments in every state, and so you can show that they partnered with VAP Kid. So it may be yet another way to get some points. And then the other way is something called EdWeb. Now, VAP Kid just did a lecture through it about ELL and different strategies, and it was really great. It was with one of their employees, and so they said you could get CE credit for it, which is pretty cool. And they even at EdWeb, when you make an account, which is free, they will send you a personalized certificate for every workshop that you attend. And they're just online, and you just attend them. There's a chat box, there's no video, and you don't have any sound on your part. So, I mean, like if your kids are being crazy, it's okay. But you just watch a lecture series, and it has a slideshow and different things, and then they interact through polls and through the chat box. But they're really cool. They're usually only an hour long. I've already attended a few, and they keep track of these certifications for you. They also email you one, but it doesn't have your name on it. So you could print it out and things like that, but it's signed and everything. Now, what's really cool is if you go to the website, you can click on your state and see if your state has already approved EdWeb as points. By the way, EdWeb is free, which is really nice. So like you can see, I clicked on California and it shows yes, that they have approved these as credits that you can use. Now in Utah, it says check with your educational department. Now what's nice about it is they give the address, website, and email of every place that isn't approved yet, so you can contact them and check and see. And so I still need to do that for Utah. You think I would do that before I started attending these workshops, but they have been really, really interesting, and I've been learning some really cool things. But these are just a few ways that may or may not help you get some points, but I just wanted to share them. I hope you all have a great day, and of course, if you have anything to add, please put it below. This will help out a lot of teachers. Thank you. Bye.